this video we will be learning surgical incisions and the needle parts of the needle and suture materials and type of sutures. This is a very important topic which has more weightage, and probability of asking an imaged voice questions from this topic is more in NEET PG. First we will see the surgical incision types. Learn surgical incisions from up to down and right to left. First is the coccus incision, which is present in the right hypochondrial region along the rib line. Next is the transverse incision in the upper abdomen, and next is midline incision. It is mostly used for the laparotomies. And next is paramedian incision, which is in a paramedian position to the midline. And coming to the incisions used for appendicectomies, there are different types of incisions. There are McBurney's incision, Battle incision, Lance incision, and Rutherford Morrison incision. These McBurney's, Battle, and Lance incisions all are presented in the same right iliac region. So to easily remember these incisions, remember that McBurney fought Battle of Lance. Remember like this, McBurney fought Battle of Lance, like this. And McBurney's is oblique, battle will be vertical, and Lance incision will be horizontal. Then coming to the incision of caesarean section, it is fenestrial incision, and next is Rutherford Morrison incision. Make sure that you practice these incisions before going to exam. Next, coming to the parts of the needle, see, the needle consists of a tip, that is a point, the body, and a swagged eye. A circular cross section in drawn body needle is seen here, and in a reverse cutting needle a triangular cross section can be seen. Point where the needle holder grasps the needle is at the junction of proximal 1/3 and the distal 2/3. This is also an important question. Then coming to the types of sutures, these image based questions asking about type of sutures are asked many times in NEET PG. Concentrate on this topic. First is simple sutures. These are simple sutures. They are individual sutures. And next is continuous suture. This is continuous suture. Next one is a mattress sutures. There are two types of mattress sutures, horizontal mattress and a vertical mattress. These are used to produce eversion and inversion of wound edges, and it is done for accurate approximation. Know the difference between these two sutures and how to identify them. Next is surgeon's knot, granny knot, and a square knot. This is a surgeon's knot. In upper side there will be two loops, and in lower thing there will be four loops. The main confusion comes between the granny knot and a square knot. This difference you should appreciate, and it is an important MCQ. In a granny knot, the crossings are opposite, that is, crossings between the dark and light bands are opposite. In the upper loop, the dark band is superficial, and in the lower loop, and white band is superficial. Then in the square knot, the crossings are same, in the same color, as we can appreciate here, both are dark over light. Next, coming to the suture materials. Coming to the catgut, it is made up of collagen from animal intestines, and it is natural absorbable twisted multifilament and monofilament, usually representative two products are surgical catguts and chromic catguts. Next, coming to the silk, it is light blue in color. It is made from fibroin from silkworm, that is Bombyx mori, and it is classified into natural non-absorbable braided multifilament. Coming to representative product or brand, Permahead soft silk. Next, coming to polypropylene, it will be in royal blue color. It is made of puff isotactic crystalline. It is a stereoisomer of polypropylene. It is classified into polypropylene. It is a synthetic and it is non-absorbable and monofilament. Example, Prolin and Sergipro. Next one is polyamide. It is sea green in color and it is made up of nylon 6 and nylon 6x. It is a synthetic non-absorbable monofilament. And examples are ethylene and dermalon. Next, coming to stainless steel, it is silver in color and it is made up of 316L low carbon stainless steel alloy, and it is classified into metal, non-absorbable, mono and multi-filaments are available. Representative product is Ethisteel and Flexon. Coming to polyglycolic acid or polylactic acid, which will be in purple color, and it is contained of 90% polyglycolic acid and 10% of polylactic acid, which is classified into synthetic absorbable braided multifilament, and representative product is Vicryl and Vicryl Rapid. Next one is polydioxanone, which will be in gray color, and which is made up of polyester p-dioxanone, which is classified into synthetic absorbable and monofilament. Representative product is PDS2. Next one and the last one is polyglycolic acid polytrimethylene carbonate, which is made up of copolymer of glycolic acid and trimethylene carbonate, which is classified into synthetic absorbable monofilament, and representative product is Maxon. In all these, catgut, silk, polypropylene are most important, and polydioxanone also important. Thank you for watching this video. For more videos, subscribe to my tuber.